Howdy, everybody. It is the 30th of June. It's a nice, dreary Tuesday. It has been raining now for 3 days, so everything is way too wet to do much out in the field. This is one of my rare days off, and I was going to go out and do some field work with Stinky, knocking down some of the weeds and the wheat in preparation for our plow disc and planting day coming up in September. So we'll see what we can come up with today for this little video. So sit back, enjoy, and don't forget to share them with all of your friends. See you in a bit. Well, I think what we're going to do first thing is we're going to go for a little ride today and see what all we can come up with to do that isn't field related. The old duck pond's looking kind of on the low side today. You can even see the top of the foot valve for the intake pipe sticking up out of the water. So I guess we'd better divert some water back down this way instead of out in the front yard. I ran out there into the field a ways with the side-by-side just to see how muddy that is. It may not be quite as wet as I thought, but just from the looks of the depth of the ruts, which are a good 5 inches right there in that plowed stuff, probably won't be as bad out yonder, but I think we'll let that ground dry out a day or two before I get out there and mow all of that wheat and weeds that are growing out there. In the meantime, we'll wander over here to the first settling pond. Now, it still has water in it, but there's none running over to the other pond. So, oh, look at all this thistle out here. Just lovely. Just lovely. We're going to open this up just a crack and let a little bit of water into the pond to refill. I don't know if you can hear it, but it sounds like that water is filling up in that pipe. And there ain't nothing coming out down there. Anybody fancy a swim to go down in there to see if that pipe's plugged? I don't know how well you can see that riser or not. By the sounds of the water, it sounds like it's clear full and it's running over. That would explain why there's water running out into the field or the staging area and into the neighboring wheat field. So yeah, I'd probably better open up that valve for the pond and the creek a little bit more. Now, I don't know if you can see the ripples in the water, but a minute ago we had a bunch of mud come gushing up. Apparently one of those big blobs of dirt from that ditch bank there that is sloughed off did land on top of that pipe where it comes up and had partially plugged it. So I diverted all the water down into it and it blew that thing up. And now it's all muddy water in there. Well, one of the things I can do today is bring these hinge pins out away from the post here because the latch pin at the other end of the gate isn't catching on the contraption on the other side. So, if I can get this wrench to work here and loosen this bolt, we'll drop that hinge and, crank those pins out a little bit. Makes good pry bar. Okay. There's that in. And that's how you do it. And I think what we'll do is we'll just crank these out one turn. Of course, the problem is I'm trying to do this with wet wood. The wood has swollen up on the hinges. Yeah, now we'll try this one, see what we can do. There. Put this end back on. Put this end up on the bridge over yonder. Slide this on and we're back in B's and M's. Tighten this up real tight. We'll see if it'll work. Yeah, that pin looks like it's getting through the inside of that latch a lot better than it was. It used to be just about flush, so I think that did it. The irrigation ditch on the lawn here for the front and side lawns on the south side of the farm, still full of water, and it is running out down by that front willow tree down there. I'm gonna put my wellies on to go out there to wander around to see how far that's gotten. But it does look like the grass has a darker green shade to it from where that water's kind of running over the side out towards the willow tree. So hopefully we're getting water clear across that front lawn. Well, since I haven't been up to check on the diversion gate here in the last couple of days, I guess I probably had better go do that. Yeah. I still haven't heard anybody's comments or anything on what you want to do here with this fence. Looks like the moisture in the last couple of days has made that split rail kind of grow back together again. But anyway, do let me know what you want to do here. If you just want me to put in a gate system in here or, yeah, whatever. As if I don't hear from you, I'm going to put a new rail in there and call it good. The ground is moist out there, but it isn't as saturated as I thought. So I'm going to go ahead and fit up the rotary mower to the back end of Stinky here, and we're going to go mow some weeds this afternoon. To fetch the mower. I really don't like mowing or doing anything when the ground is this moist. But since I have a job in town, I don't have but just a few days every month where I can actually get out here and do something at the farm. So now the sun's kind of come out a little bit here and there. I'm not getting stuck yet. Bogging down in a few places, especially along the fence there where the water was running over the top of that diversion thing. But yeah, I gotta get her done. It ain't gonna get done in time for September if I don't. Normally have a lot of time to do much of anything out in the field, and today's no exception. I have that coming. Yeah, there's another storm coming. If I'm gonna get this mowed, I better hurry up and get her done. So you'll excuse me if I don't film all this, because I'm gonna need my hands, because I'm gonna be traveling fast and I'm gonna have to make adjustments and steer. So you're just gonna have to use your imagination on what I was doing mowing. Yeah. I don't know about you a lot, but I don't think it's any too soon to be getting out of this field. There's thunder and lightning out there in that. So yeah, we're gonna finish up this little stretch and go in. I think that's going to about do it for today. We've got a lot of thunder and lightning going on out here coming this way. And as always, right down there, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and the little bell icon right next to it. When you click on that, there's three words that come up. Click on all. That way you can get notified every time there's a new video out. So yeah, there's more thunder coming. So I think that's going to wrap up today's little video. We'll get something else done here in the next day or two, and we'll finish up that mowing job out there in the wheat field. In the meantime, stay dry.